Welcome to the Vue File Upload tutorial. With this Syncfusion Vue File Upload component, you can upload one or multiple files, images, documents, audio, video, and other files to a server. You can explore the component's extensive feature set, which includes multiple file selection, progress bars, auto-uploading, drag and drop, directory uploading, file validation, and more. In this video, I will show you how to get started with the Syncfusion Vue File Upload component. I will explain how to configure the component with a few of its basic features, like uploading a single file or multiple files at a time, and validation during file upload. Also, I will show you how to upload files asynchronously. Let me start with the application creation process. I'm going to create a Vue application using the Vue Vite command. Make sure you have installed the latest versions of Vue and Node.js to follow along. I will edit my code using Visual Studio Code and finally view the output result in the Chrome browser. To create a project in Vue, open Visual Studio Code and in the terminal, type the command npm create vite at latest. Provide the app name. Select the Vue framework and the variant JavaScript. Navigate to the project folder and run the npm install command to install the required dependencies. Now the application is configured with the default settings of a Vue project. To add the Syncfusion Vue file upload component, install the package using the command npm install at syncfusion ej2vueinputs. This command installs the vueinputs package along with its dependencies. I then need to register a trial license key to use Syncfusion components. Open the main.js file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, register the trial license key. To see how to generate this license key, refer to the link in the description below. The application is now configured with the license to use Syncfusion Vue components. To start using the file upload component, open the app.vue page and remove the default code. Then add the script tag and import the uploader component from the Syncfusion EJ2 vueinputs package. Define the uploader component in the components collection with a tag name. This way, you can use this tag and create the file upload component within the template. Add a template tag, and within it, add a division element, and set a class name to apply CSS styles for better alignment. Add the EJS uploader tag. To apply CSS styles to file upload component, I import the necessary material theme CSS references. Additionally, implement the division element class style to position it at the top center of the page and set its width to fit the content. Save this application and run it using the command npm run dev. You can see the file upload component is rendered in the application. There are three options to upload a file. Use the browse button, drop the file directly in the drop area, or copy and paste the file. Notice here, you can see the status ready to upload and you can remove any file from this list. By default, you can select multiple files and upload them simultaneously. To restrict uploads to a single file, you must disable the multiple property. To do so, in the uploader component, bind the multiple property with the value false. Checking now, I can select only one file and upload it. Even when I drag multiple files, only the last selected file will be uploaded. Next, I will show you how to enable asynchronous uploading. To do that, I need to specify the save and remove URLs in the uploader component's async settings property. To define the property in the script tag, add the data function. Within it, return the async settings property with the save and remove URLs. These service URLs are hosted on the server that contains the file uploader controller with save and remove APIs. Let me show you the save and remove server-side APIs. In the file uploader controller class, the save method is used to save each uploaded file to the server's directory. The method retrieves the file from the HTTP request, checks whether a file with the same name does not already exist in the specified path, and then creates the file using the saveAS method. In the remove method, the file name is retrieved from the HTTP request, and the file is deleted from the specified location using the file class's delete method if the file exists. Now, when I browse and select a file, it will be uploaded, and the uploaded status is shown at the bottom. If I click the Delete File button in the Upload list, the file will be deleted. Next, I will show you how to validate files before uploading them to the server. By default, the File Uploader component allows you to upload a minimum file size of 0 bytes and a maximum file size of 28.4 megabytes. To restrict uploads, I can use the min file size and max file size properties, which accept values in bytes. For example, in the Uploader component, I set the min file size to 20,000 bytes, which is 20 kilobytes, and I set the max file size to 40,000 bytes, which is 40 kilobytes. Let me upload a 15 KB file. As expected, attempting to upload a file smaller than our specified minimum triggers a file size is too small error message. Next, let me try a file that is larger than 40 KB. It shows the file size is too large error message. Now I upload the file within the allowed size range. The file uploads successfully to the server without any issues. Finally, I will show you how to upload specific file types. In the Uploader component, bind the allowed extensions property with a string value that contains extension types PNG and VTT. Now, when I browse, only PNG and VTT files are shown for selection. I can select any of them. When I drag and drop a PDF file, I get the error message, file type is not allowed. In this video, I have shown you how to create and configure the Syncfusion Vue File Upload component and how to use a few of its basic features. You can download the example used in this video from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also included a link where you can check if you're eligible for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire Vue suite. If you found this video useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to get notifications about new videos. Thanks for watching.